Practicing, giving, etc. May I attain Buddhahood for the sake of all that lives. On the crown of my and all sentient beings is a white lotus and moon on which a re-transforms into Chenrezig, radiating white clear light of five colors. Gazing with compassionate eyes and a loving smile, with forearms two folded in prayer, the lower two holding a crystal rosary and white lotus. He is arrayed with jewels and silk, with a doe skin over his shoulder. Amitabha is his head ornament. His two feet are in the Vajra Asana. A stainless moon supports his back. He is the essence of our refuge. Chonchi Magu Kudo. Lord, not veiled by any fault. A white color with a perfect Buddha as your head jewel. You gaze compassionately on all beings. To you, Chenrezig, I prostrate. To the noble, powerful Chenrezig, those of the 10 directions, the 3 times, the conquerors and their disciples, all of them I make complete and humble obeisance. Flowers, incense, light, perfume, food, and muse, these offerings, both real and imagined, I offer. May this noble assembly accept them. From beginningless time until now, I repent the 10 non-virtuous actions and the 5 heinous sins when overpowered by the obscuring passion. With all the other sins I have committed, I confess. I rejoice in the merits of the Shravakas, Projeka, Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and ordinary beings gathered in the 3 times. I pray that the wheel of Dharma be turned in the form of the greater and lesser vehicle according to the wishes and mentality of the many kinds of beings. I pray that until samsara is empty, the Buddhas will not pass into nirvana, but look upon all beings that are drowning in the ocean of suffering. The merit I accumulate, I dedicate to thee, that on reaching enlightenment, I may develop without delay the qualities of a savior of beings. I pray to you, Lama Chenrezig. I pray to you, Yidam Chenrezig. I pray to you, Noble Chenrezig, Supreme Chenrezig. I pray to you, our Protector Chenrezig. I pray to you, Lord of Love Chenrezig. Buddha of great compassion, hold me fast in your compassion. From time without beginning, beings have wandered in samsara, undergoing unendurable suffering. They have no other protector than you. Please bless them that they achieve the omniscient state of Buddhahood. Through the power of bad karma gathered throughout time without begin, beings are born by the force of hatred in hell. These beings undergoing the suffering of excess heat and cold, most perfect of deities, Chenrezig, may they be born in your presence. Time without begin, beings are born by the force of miserliness as hungry ghosts. These beings undergoing the suffering of hunger and thirst, may they be born in the most perfect realm of Potala. Throughout time without beginning, beings are born by the force of stupidity as animals. These beings undergoing the suffering of helpless ignorance, may they be born in your presence, O Protector. Beings are born through the force of attachment in the realm of humans. Held in the suffering of worldly world, may all sentient beings experience the perfect fields of day watching and be reborn there. Jealousy as demigods. These beings undergoing the suffering of quarrel, may they be born in the realm of Potala. Yeah. throughout time without beginning. Beings are born by the force of pride as gods. These beings undergoing the suffering of falling to a lower birth, may they be born in the realm of Potala. Act in the same manner as Chenrezig. By this means may all beings be liberated from the impure realm, and may the most perfect sound of the six-letter mantra spread in the 10 directions. By the power of this prayer to you, most noble and perfect, may all beings be trained by me, take karma and its effects into account, and practice skillful acts diligently. May I be one possessing dharma for the benefit of beings. By having prayed like this one-pointedly, the body of the noble one radiates light. This purifies illusory perceptions of impure karmic manifestations. The outer vessel becomes a realm of Devach, the body, speech, and mind of beings within become the body, speech, and mind of Chenrezig. Appearance, sound, and mental perception become none other than void. Together with a great gathering of monks and bodhisattvas. At that time the Blessed One entered the samadhi, which examines the dark, called profound illumination, and at the same time noble Avalokiteshvara, the bodhisattva Mahasiddha, looking at the profound practice of transcendent knowledge, saw the five skandhas and their natural emptiness. Then through the inspiration of the Buddha, Shariputra said to Avalokiteshvara, how should these noble ones learn who wish to follow the profound practice of transcendent knowledge? And Avalokiteshvara answered, Shariputra, whoever wishes to follow the profound practice of transcendent knowledge should look at it like this, seeing the five skandhas and their natural emptiness. Home is emptiness. Emptiness itself is form. Emptiness is no other than form. Form is no other than emptiness. In the same way, feeling, perception, concept, and consciousness are emptiness. Thus all the Dhammas are emptiness and have no characteristics. They are unborn and unceasing. They are not impure or pure. They neither decrease nor increase. Therefore, since there is emptiness, there is no form, no feeling, no perception, no concept, no consciousness, no eye, no ear, no nose, no tongue, no body, no mind, no appearance, no smell, no taste, no taste, no sensation, no objects of mind, no quality of sight, no quality of hearing, no quality of smell, no quality of taste, no quality of sense, no quality of thought, no quality of mind consciousness. There are no nirdhanas from ignorance to old age and death, nor their wearing out. There is no suffering, no cause of suffering, no ending of suffering, and no power, no wisdom, no attainment, and no non-attainment. Therefore, since there is no attainment, the bodhisattvas abide by means of transcendent knowledge. And since there is no obscurity of mind, they have no fear. They transcend falsity and pass beyond the bounds of sorrow. All the Buddhas who dwell in the past, present, and future by means of transcendent knowledge, fully and clearly awakened to unsurpassed true complete enlightenment. Therefore, the mantra of transcendent knowledge, the mantra of deep insight, the unsurpassed mantra, the unequaled mantra, the mantra which calms all suffering, should be known as truth, for there is no deception. In transcendent knowledge, the mantra is proclaimed. Om Gate Gate Para Gate Para Sangate Bodhisattva. Shariputra, this is how a bodhisattva, mahasattva, should learn profound transcendent knowledge. And the Blessed One arose from that samadhi and praised the bodhisattva, mahasattva, Avalokiteshvara, say, good, good, O son of noble family, profound transcendent knowledge should be practiced just as you have taught, and the Tathagatas will rejoice. When the Blessed One had said this, Shariputra and Avalokiteshvara, that whole gathering and the world with its gods, men, Zurs and Gandharvas, their hearts full of joy, praise the words of the Blessed One.
Yeah.
By this act of virtue, may I quickly reach the level of Chenrezig, and then establish all beings, leaving no remainder on that level. Connected to immediately we leave this body, be miraculously born in Dewachen. As soon as we are born, may we send out emanations in the 10 directions, performing the benefit of others.
繁茂树，遍尽梅香溢。